Sarah Sanders is with me now. Good morning to you. And I should, as you well know, we may have to interrupt this interview. We'll see how much we can plow through here. Has the president told Bill Barr what he should do, Sarah?
I'm not aware that he's instructed him to do anything. What I am aware of is how much the Democrats embarrassed themselves yesterday. The outrageous questioning that they laid out to the attorney general, frankly, was astonishing. You just showed a clip of Senator Hirono, the outrage that she came to the attorney general, who came there and sat for 5 hours of questioning, was just unbelievable. And the hearing that you mentioned that we may have to cut away for with Jerry Nadler, in which there is no witness, is because the Democrats are, frankly, they saw what happened yesterday and they've decided that they're incapable of actually asking questions of the attorney general. Look, I lost confidence in Jerry Nadler a long time ago, but I was unaware that he had lost confidence in himself and his ability to do his job, and that is to ask questions. The fact that he needs to staff that out is unbelievable, okay, and frankly, it's pathetic. Democrats
Nadler,
have got to step up.
Nadler said a lot. Actually, they determined this format before yesterday, to have some members of the committee staff, lawyers, ask the questions. Apparently, it's not going to happen because Bill Barr won't be there. But just a question on this. Why not go ahead and appear at the hearing and get it over with?
Look, the attorney general sat for 5 hours yesterday, Bill, and he answered every question put in front of him. He was willing to sit down and do that again with the House, but naturally the Democrats have changed the rules middle of the game. They took a vote yesterday, a special vote, in order to allow staff to question the attorney general. He's a cabinet member for the president of the United States, and this is a straightforward oversight hearing in which members of Congress should be able to ask those questions. They shouldn't need to staff that out. In fact, a number of these members are attorneys themselves and should be perfectly fine making those asks and doing that all on their own without having somebody else do that.
As you know, it's rare, but it's not unprecedented to do this. Say 1987,
it's completely unnecessary.
Just,
it's pathetic. They can't do their own job.
It happened during Watergate in the early 1970s, et cetera, and I understand the point you're making. Will the White House try and prevent Don McGahn and others appearing before a House or Senate committee going forward?
Look, we've been transparent from the beginning of this entire process. We've put forward dozens of people to talk with the special counsel, 1.4 million pages of documents. We've been fully transparent and cooperative, but this thing is over. It's time for Democrats to move on. They can't continue to drag this thing out. They can't continue to put the American people through this. Look, there was no collusion. There was no obstruction. And now they need to come together and work with the president to actually fix real problems. They've shown that they're not capable of working with us on immigration, but maybe they could help on infrastructure or lowering prescription drug prices. There are a lot of things that we have to be able to look the American people in the eye and say, we're working for you. We're doing things to help you, not just continuing to attack the president. And they've got to get to a point where they love this country more than they hate this president. And so far, we're not seeing that from them at any point, and particularly on what they're doing in display today.
If they then file a subpoena later today against Barr or some point down the road, or McGahn or whomever, you know, take your pick in the administration, are you willing to fight that in court as long as it takes to prevent them from appearing?
You know, we'll see what happens. I'm not going to get ahead of the process, and we'll play those cards as they come. But at this point, I think we've been very clear, and I think that the information that is in front of the entire public that Attorney General Bill Barr has put forward, because he put that report out, has shown that there is no collusion, there is no obstruction, and it's time to move on and focus on some of the real problems that face our country.
Okay, I'm getting word that Bill Barr just left his house. Not sure where he's going. He's probably going to the office at the Department of Justice. We'll see where he ends up today. On Venezuela, Maduro has proven to be a pretty stubborn man. Has he won?
Not at all. This is something that we knew wasn't going to be a one-day process. It's something that is going to take some time. Maduro's a fighter. There's no question about that. But the people of Venezuela are hurting. Many of them are without food. They're without water. They're without the needed medical supplies, life-threatening illnesses that some of these people have. They're fleeing by the millions, and something has to be done, and Maduro needs to step down and allow the people of his country to thrive and to survive and live in freedom.
I apologize for interrupting our conversation here. I hope you come back. Sarah Sanders from the White House.
Absolutely. Thanks, Bill.